Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. I am Anna and I'm a little bit spooky. Today we are gonna be digging in my trash, just living it up, being the trash people we know we truly are inside. Just rooting in there like little raccoons. That's what we're up to today. It's little trash pandas. If you want to see how I got this look that I'm wearing, there will be a tutorial coming up, or it may already be up. Either way, it'll get linked in the cards or in the description box somewhere. This is a winterberry look inspired by Royalty Soaps, their winterberry soap. It is that time again though for digging in the trash. Let's see, this will be my empties for November and October. The last empties we did, I believe, was September. I can't remember. I do it every other month. I don't have that much. Look, I just got this little bag. Not too bad, huh? Little gift bag. This is actually from my other favorite artisan soap place, the bathhouse. Not spawns. So let's go ahead and see what empties I have, because I honestly don't remember. I've just been sticking stuff in here. Wow, okay, so I don't have a whole lot. So hopefully this will be a short, quick video to the point, because I've been posting some long-ins lately. I know. I've had a lot to film and talk about and do. I'm sorry. Let's just go ahead and start with hair care and what I've used up there. One thing, my Magic Root Cover-Up from L'Oreal. This is my magic trick to blend my roots, which are green in comparison to this color, and I thought I had red hair. No, apparently not. It's just ash when it grows out and then turns red as it gets longer for some reason. You know, this is overtone, but yeah, I have a very strange natural hair color that doesn't know what it wants to be. Like, it's red yet ash at the same time. I don't know. So anyways, when I have a hair color in, it never matches whatever hair color I have. So I just use dark brown root cover up from L'Oreal just to kind of blend things in up here, make everything look all nice and cohesive, and I can cover up where I've got foundation in my hair, and it kind of also adds some nice texture and works like a dry shampoo. I kind of love this stuff so much. So I have it in today. It's just blending everything into my little bit of a balayage ombre situation, because my roots are grown out quite a bit since I got it done, which you can see my natural roots over here, I think. You see how they're kind of gold, but a different shade of gold than the rest of my hair. So this is the overtone that I just did a first impressions on and everything. This is it, two washes without using the conditioner to keep it up. I was just testing how it fades. And it's holding in there pretty damn good. It's gotten a little bit brighter and lighter. Like, it's very brassy. I don't hate it. I like it with a dark root. But if I had this color all over, I would probably hate it. But anyway, yeah. So I went through one of these. I go through one of these maybe every 3 weeks or so. I buy them every 2 weeks when I go grocery shopping. So I do tear through quite a few of these because there's not much in it. And depending on how often I wash my hair and style it, how much I use it. Sometimes one will last me a month. On average, they last me about 2 weeks, and I usually just spray along here and along here before I do my makeup and a touch up afterwards if I've got like a splotch of foundation. But I do love these. They don't run, they don't get all over your hands or anything. It dries down, it's locked in, and doesn't come out until you shampoo your hair. So like, you can sleep in it and stuff, and it may come off from your pillow a little bit, but it's not gonna get everywhere. And that's all for hair stuff. As much hair stuff as I buy, you'd think I'd tear through it more. No. Let's move on to some skincare. I have used up some skincare, and I'm very, very, very sad about this one. This is my Tatcha Violet C. I always wanna call it Violet. Violet C Brightening Serum. I really enjoyed this serum. It was lovely. She did what she claims. It was, let's see, it is made with Japanese angelica roots, dual vitamin C for all skin types. This lasted me about a year, so not bad. It's very, very expensive, and I will probably not repurchase because I do not have an extra nearly $100 lying around for just some vitamin C serum. But yeah, I did really, really enjoy using it and loved it. And the bottle is beautiful. I still have my essence I'm working through. Haven't used that up yet. Next is the Pixie Skin Treats Glycolic Cleansing Tonic. This is made with glycolic acid and Yeah, glycolic acid. It's hard to read because it's reflective and I got the lights. But yeah, this is an exfoliating cleanser, chemical exfoliant. I really enjoyed using it. It was very different than any other cleanser I've ever used. It doesn't bubble or foam, it just works. And I felt like it did a great job on my skin. I think I had some good skin days while I was using it. It helped me get my skin back on track from some unfortunate other products. So will I repurchase this? Oh, most definitely. I just gotta get to Target. I've been over there lately. I went through a Neutrogena oil-free makeup remover. I love these. This is my next favorite next to the Mary Kay. This is quite nice. Oh, and the Lancome one. That one's really good too. I use this one, or I'll use the Equate one. They're the same. It just depends whichever I see at the store first. I usually try to get the Equate one because it's a little bit cheaper. Because it doesn't matter. But yeah, this is a great little product. Use these constantly to get off lash glue, stubborn mascara, liner, and all that. It doesn't quite get the lash glue off though. I haven't found anything that really gets lash glue completely off your eyeballs. Okay, let's move on to some makeup that I've used up. I have a few things. This isn't really actually used up, it's just expired at this point and I didn't love it enough to repurchase. But this is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation in porcelain. I don't think it's the best shade match for me. I really don't like the liquid, and this is oxidized because it's old. And you know, I might like it better if I repurchased it and tried it again, but I don't recall enjoying it enough to want to try it again. Unless you guys just really want a review. I don't know. So yeah, I didn't even use it up. It's expired, it's gotten weird, it's time for it to go. Another foundation from Wet n Wild, this one I have used up. This is the Cushion Foundation with SPF 15. I love this so much. Even though it's a hair dark for me, it's so sheer, you can't tell. Beautiful product, great for just throwing on to get out the door. You need something quick and easy, this is it. Inside it's a little compact here. You get the little poof, the little puff, poof, puff. And your product's right in here and you just push on it and then tap it around the skin. I do actually have some product left in this. This is just, again, expired and it's time to go. I have a brand new one that's not been opened yet, ready to go. Because this is something that I do, like, kind of throw in my bag or my really quick need to get out the door days. This is what I use just to even out my skin tone because I do have a lot of redness and sometimes I don't want my face looking bright red while the rest of my body looks like a ghost. Next up is something a little controversial, but I was just trying to quietly use it up in the background. But this is the Kat Von D Locket Concealer Whiteout. Yeah, I still could probably get some out of this, but I've had it for quite some time. I think it's about expired and there's better white concealers on the market, I'd imagine. The Locket foundation, or the Locket concealer formula isn't my favorite. So I just got this because it was white and I needed a white one to mix in with some other products. But yeah, I will probably be purchasing a different brand of this because I don't purchase from Kat Von D anymore, unfortunately, but I'm choosing not to support her anymore. And it's hard to separate her from the brand because she is so hands-on with the brand. Which is unfortunate because I do think there's a lot of beauty in the brand itself, in the products, and yeah, she just ruined it for a lot of people. So yeah, this is unfortunately though going in the trash, and I'll probably need to declutter some more of her stuff that's just expired at this point. But I'm behind the scenes trying to use up a lot of the older Kat Von D products that I have that I don't want to feature on my channel. Because I'm just not going to feature them, but I'm not going to throw them away until they're done. I'm not gonna waste product either. Let's see, I got a brow pencil that I have used up, of course. This is Wet n Wild medium brown retractable brow pencil. I just bought a replacement of this. I love it, especially for everyday. Just throw it in, good to go. It's a lovely brow pencil for a very good price point. I've used up the e.l.f. brow pencil, which is also really nice. I think this is in, oh, it doesn't have the shade name on it, but it's not quite a micro brow, but it's small. This is, I think, in just the dark brown shade or brunette or something. It's lovely. Again, I like to use it for every day as well. It's a little bit warmer in the Wet n Wild ones. So sometimes I mix them depending on what's going on in the hair situation, because I never know what my hair color's gonna look like. It's fading and stuff. You never know what you're gonna get. So right now I'm just sticking to brown. Just kind of a very neutral brown. A Wet n Wild liquid liner pen, which has broke and the cap would not stay back on it. You see, these just fall apart. I like these, but they are very shittily made. My brown ones lasted, but I've gone through like three of these, and you know, it's like I could just buy a good one for the price I've spent. I think how many I've spent buying one of these like every couple weeks or whatever. So yeah, I've bought two new liquid liners to try out instead, but it's a shame because I enjoy this liquid liner quite a bit, but oh well. Lastly is one I'm sad about, which is my NARS Via Veneto liner. It is completely gone. I loved this eyeliner so much in the waterline. Like, it actually stayed and it didn't irritate my eyes. So I'm probably gonna buy a backup of this whenever I get over to Sephora or place an order or whatever. It takes me forever to get around to buying something like that. So I would like to know a good drugstore option. If anyone has a black pencil liner that is super waterproof, long lasting, and doesn't irritate your waterline and make your eyes burn the next day, let me know. That is one of the biggest problems I have with eyeliners in the waterline, is that they make my eyes incredibly irritated the next day. And last thing, oh my gosh, we are already done. A Sinful top coat. I know I don't have my nails done today, but I've been working with my hands a lot lately. And there's no point in me doing my nails because they're getting tore up. But this is a Sinful Colors. Sinful Shine top coat. This is supposed to be like a gel top coat. These dry out quite fast and they get very gloopy and thick. So I do replace these about once a month. So I don't actually ever get them used up, but they are a really nice top coat for like $1.99 at Walmart. A very chip resistant. I use this in combination with a base coat that is from another brand that's really cheap, just with whatever polish suits me that day. It's either usually OPI or Sinful. But yeah, I tore through one of these. I've already got a replacement. And yeah, that is all my empties. I thought I had a lot more than I did. Oh well, that is it for this video. If you enjoyed digging in the trash with me and just reveling in our garbage person mentalities, what are your most used up products? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see y'all in the next one. Bye now.